this machine could have saved many young, healthy adults from COVID-19. More than 2 years since the pandemic began, nearly 6 million people have died due to COVID-19. That staggering number included adults, the elderly, and children. Though many young adults shouldn't have died if only they had access to a kind of therapy, which was hammered badly by shortages. Early into this pandemic, the healthcare sector scrambled for anything that could work against the disease. From existing drugs to supportive therapies, everything humanly possible to save lives and until specific treatments became available. We eventually reached that point where vaccines and select COVID-19 treatments were authorized. One of the treatments for COVID-19 is called extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, or ECMO, a machine that provides cardiac and respiratory support. This is something you can get in many health facilities. Yet access to it can be problematic if there's a global health crisis like COVID-19. The shortage happened since COVID-19 attacks the lungs, and the demand surged as cases skyrocketed. Even when saving ECMO for the youngest, healthiest, and sickest patients, we could only provide it to a fraction of patients who qualified for it, said Whitney Gannon, Director of Quality and Education for the Vanderbilt Extracorporeal Life Support Program. At Vanderbilt University Medical Center, researchers investigated why many young and relatively healthy adults died because of COVID-19. The scope of their study was the total number of patients referred for ECMO in one referral region between January 1, 2021 and August 31, 2021. Published in the American Journal of Respiratory and Critical Care Medicine, researchers found two notable groups of ECMO patients, those who received and those qualified for but didn't receive. Around 90% of patients who qualified for ECMO but failed to get the treatment died, compared to 43% of those who received ECMO, despite having young age and limited comorbidities. That's around half of the chance to survive cut, simply due to shortages. It showed how unprepared the world is against a pandemic, even after what we've experienced in the past. The shortages weren't easy to solve during the peak of the pandemic. When a patient was determined eligible for ECMO, another assessment was done to pull resources and grant an ECMO treatment. But when resources weren't available, the patient couldn't be transferred to an ECMO center and be treated. Hospitals were overwhelmed, and most people outside of medicine don't know this. Medical centers couldn't handle thousands of patients pouring in daily. Resources were strained and the staff was thinned, as many hospital workers also contracted COVID-19. Hopefully, after this pandemic, world leaders will finally realize that the healthcare system really needs big upgrades. What's your take on this study? Did you know someone who didn't get ECMO for COVID-19 because of shortages? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.